Advertising. Advertising is the market tactics involving paying for space to promote a product or services. The actual promotional messages are called advertisement. Advertisement is the process of spreading product information among the potential buyer through a public medium in order to maximize the sale. The goal of advertising is to reach people most likely to be willing to pay for a company's product or services and provoke them to buy. William J. Stanston defined as advertising consists of all the activities involved in presenting to a group a non-personal, oral or visual, openly sponsored message regarding a product, services or idea. Objectives of advertising: to announce the introduction of a new product, to motivate the buyers to buy, to create demand for the product, to achieve an immediate sale, to announce certain concession to the buyers like discount, price cut, gifts, etc., to popularize the brand name and to secure brand loyalty, to support the activities and effort of the salesman, to build up image for the business, to achieve a higher market share, to inform product modification and alternation to the buyer, to explain how the product works, to counter the competitors' strategies, to promote sales during off-season, to maximize sales during festival season, to remind the buyers about the company and its products. So these are the main objectives of advertising. Kinds of advertising. The first one is product advertising. Most business houses try to sell their product and services through advertising. The need for the product advertising arises mainly because the business has to create demand for its product. This is being done through a public medium like newspaper, television, and radio. The second one is institutional advertising. Here, the focus is on the company and its service. Such an advertisement is not intended for the consumers alone. It may also mean for the various group like the shareholders, creditors, suppliers and so on. The third one is competitive advertising. In this case, the goal of advertisement is to show the superiority of the product over the competing product. The fourth one is comparative advertising. Here, the marketer highlights the comparative features of the competing product. Such advertisements are quite common these days. And also, here become a matter of controversy. The fifth one is collective and cooperative advertising. Certain products are jointly advertised by the manufacturer and the dealers together. Such an advertising is what is known as collective or cooperative advertising. The sixth one is non-commercial advertising. Such advertisements are brought out by charitable organizations mainly to secure financial help from others. So these are the kinds of advertising. Factors determining advertising. The first one is product differentiation. The product that is being marketed now must be capable of being differentiated from similar products that are already available in the market. The difference may be found in its size, shape, color, flavor, taste, and so on. Second one is want satisfy capacity. It is important that the product must be capable of satisfying certain unfulfilled needs of the buyer. For example, if a new detergent powder is marketed and if it is very effective in removing the stains means, such a quality may be highlighted in the advertisement. The third one is emotional buying motives. If the desire to buy a product is induced by such emotions like pride, ego, status, prestige means it can offer greater scope for advertisement. The fourth one is availability of fund. Availability of finance plays an important role in determining the use of advertisement as a promotional tool. If finance is not a constraint, means the business may rely on any other media for advertising its product. The fifth one is number of buyers. Advertisement is necessary only if a large number of buyers in different part of country and use their product. If product users are very few in number and also found in certain area, means there is no need to serve the advertisement. And also personal selling is more suitable for this case. Sixth one is nature of the product. If the products are homogeneous in nature means and also quickly perishable means there is no need to advertise the product. And also there is no scope for advertisement. Sales promotion. Sales promotion can be defined as an activity taken up to boost the sales of a product. It can include distribution of free samples, offering free gifts, conducting trade fairs, exhibition and competition, offering temporary price discounts. Encouraging the customers to try a new product, attract new customers, encouraging customers to use the product or services and make them to brand loyal, counter a competitor's promotional activities. These are the purpose of sales promotion. Importance of sales promotion. When sellers introduce new product or new brand in the market. When an economy is going through a recessionary phase, customers become more price sensitive. When sellers aim at triggering the impulsive buying behavior of the customer. A company seeks to obtain greater cooperation from its retailer. Price promotion, coupons, free gifts and samples, money refund, frequent users incentives, points of purchase display, installment offers, consumer contest, consumer sweepstakes, trade shows. So these are the methods are used in sales promotion. Public relation. The planned and sustained effort to establish and maintain goodwill and mutual understanding between an organization and its public. Public includes its employees, stakeholders, trade unions, general public, customers, media, government and politicians, etc. Setting objectives, building awareness, building credibility, motivate sales forces, cut down promotional cost. These are the major decisions in public relations. Customer communications like customer press release, promotional videos, product launch events, business communication through company videos, direct mailing, trade press release, trade exhibition, etc. The third one is employee communication, in-house newsletters, notice board, company get-together. So these are the techniques used in public relation. Direct marketing. Direct marketing is a type of advertising campaign that seeks to bring an action in a selected group of consumers. It involves to presenting information about a product or services to a target consumers without the use of an advertising middleman. Benefits of direct marketing. You can reach your specific audience segment with personalized messages. and you can set realistic goals and improve your sales on a tight budget. You can communicate with your current customers as well as the older customer. It creates new sales opportunities. Direct contact with your customers allows you to customize your promotions, email and offers to create an instant bond. Direct marketing allows you to adapt the market demands at all the time and respond more effectively. Direct response campaign gives you the opportunity to directly measure your results. Telemarketing. Telemarketing is the process of using the telephone to make sales or gather marketing information. It is a valuable tool for small business. It saves time and money as compared with personal selling. It offers many of the same benefits in terms of direct contact with the customers. Advantages of telemarketing. Human interaction. Particularly valuable tool for small business. Building a long-term business success and increasing the value of the company, telemarketing customer service can gain repeat order and increase the penetration of the customer base. Telemarketing has the advantage of delivering excellent customer services. It is a way to reduce the cost of selling. It is also easier to communicate with the customers. Most of the marketing efforts are directly towards select market. It is the most flexible form of direct marketing. It helps to knowing and understanding what the customers want and are prepared to buy. Now, virtual contacts with the customers is possible. More people are using technology to screen out unwanted callers, particularly telemarketers. A telephone conversation has very short memory. Pre-purchase inspections of goods is not possible. It can be extremely expensive, particularly if telemarketing is outsourced to an outside firm. These are the disadvantages of telemarketing. Thank you.